With 10 days to go, the Hawks made it to the Canary Islands, and next will cross the Bay of Biscay, on the way to her final destination of Stavanger in Norway. But Captain Ilian has found a weather complication on the radar.
We are looking for this development of this low pressure. It's coming down from the northwest to the southeast.
There's a North Atlantic storm front developing over the next couple of days, ahead of their route across the Bay of Biscay.
And most probably we will meet this bad weather in this area.
On deck, rig manager Tor and technical section leader Klaus Mortensen are checking the rig's readiness for the storms.
We're just doing a visual inspection before the weather is hitting us. How's it going, Alex?
We're getting there now, it's like one completely
on
green.
A long voyage like this, we constantly monitor the legs' movements.
The legs constantly move within their guide plates, and it creates quite a noise. But if the winds pick up and the Hawk pitches and rolls, there will be a lot of stress on the legs, and they can be permanently damaged if they bend in a storm.
Where most stress is this area we're at now.
Supporting such a massive structure is a challenge.
And from here on, it's about 170 meters up in the air with no suspension.
Okay, alter course to the 025.
The Hawk is less than 24 hours away from the rough weather system off the Bay of Biscay.
We experience now a big swell from the north, about 2-3 meters.
Captain Ilian and Chief Officer Yevgeny scrutinize the changing weather forecasts. They can't sail through waves that are any higher than 4 meters.
If you look deeper to the next 2 days, we can see that this weather is coming again, the worse and worse.
Captain Ilian faces a dilemma. He can't sail through the storm, but each day their arrival in Norway is delayed costs nearly $500,000. His only hope is a small window of opportunity to outrace the storm.
So you please be on the standby in the engine room and just wait for our order from the bridge.
We can see how this bad weather is moving.
He has a tough decision to make. Wait out the storm, head for shelter, or try to outrun it. An updated forecast adds another problem. Now there's a second weather system shaping up behind them. It threatens potential 4-meter swells. If the captain waits out the storm ahead, the Hawk could get hammered from behind.
2.6, there's a swell. We have to go with the maximum ahead.
Decision made. He'll try to outrun the storm ahead.
If we will proceed with a speed more than 10, 11 knots, it will be better for us.
Jonathan, call me electrician. Electrician is in workshop.
Captain Ilian's decision causes a chain reaction in the ship. All hands move quickly to prepare for what lies ahead. Routine maintenance becomes essential as the engineers perform a bearings check on auxiliary engine number 3. Under normal conditions, the main engine has an 18,000 horsepower capacity and consumes more than 40 tons of heavy fuel each day. But Chief Engineer Sergio Sojic is concerned that the bad weather will strain the engines.
They say that it'll be worse. We'll see.
The Hawk is currently moving at 11 knots or 20 kilometers per hour. But with a 33,000-ton cargo on deck, Captain Ilian may have to pull back on the power to protect the engines.
Bridge to bridge. Yes, hello. I have an unexpected swell from my port side approaching.
As the weather picks up, the rig is both a help and a hindrance. The heavy load stabilizes the ship so it doesn't roll from side to side. But the main living quarters and legs catch a lot of wind. So when the Hawk sails directly into the breeze, it strains to move forward. And now the speed has dropped to 8 knots. But the ship can't turn back.
We've actually come to the point of no return at the moment, so we'll just have to hope Hawk can keep up the speed.
When the squall is approaching, we can expect wind more than 40, 45 knots.
At around 8 o'clock, the leading edge of the storm catches the Hawk.
Yeah, I'm standing and looking here down on Hawk's deck. Some pretty big waves coming in over the deck. I'm guessing about 4+ meters.
Rig manager Tor orders his team out onto the deck to secure the supplies against the wind.
I'm thinking about the people on board, and if we have guys walking out on deck during the nighttime, get hit by some of the equipment, it may cause some serious injury.
I would like to increase the RPM and the power to the main engine.
Captain Ilion switches between visual checks of the rig and monitoring his guidance instruments.
Oh, now we catch the waves in the port side. This water is running through the deck. I would say this is the worst condition now we are experiencing this voyage.
As they forge through the swells, everyone worries about the cargo on deck.
When the Hawk goes down, the rig slams down to the top of the waves, and that causes some huge stress on the structure underneath the hull.
We'll make turn to the starboard side. It will be better for us for a few minutes.
Bridge, yeah. Please report wind force and direction.
Wind force 100 degrees from port side, 37 knots.
If they can't outrun the converging weather systems, the Hawk will be caught right in the center of the storm.